Hi, I'm Tricia Clemens, Chief Fur Wrangler with MuttButs.com. I'm a social media content creator for pet businesses. And in this video, I'm going to talk to you about different ways to create great photos and graphics to use to share in your newsletter, in your blog, and also on social media. Make sure you stay tuned to the end because I have a free download of my top 7 places that I like to go to get free images to use. What they're called is CC0 images. So the first thing I like to do is find different images, and I have that download for you. I'm going to tell you where you can get that at the end. But the first place I like to use is Pixabay. That's my favorite place to go to for free images that you can make any adjustments or changes to, and you don't have to put any attributions on it. That's the first place I go. Then the second thing I do is I use Canva. Canva is a free online service that you can make all kinds of different sizes, make all kinds of changes to those images, and I'm going to show you now how I do that. If you have an account, you can create a free account, sign up with Facebook, Google, or an email account, and it is free to have one. They also have upgraded accounts as well. It'll have a list of different images that you have previously done, if you have any, but you can go in and select what size you want. It has the social media, Facebook, Instagram, let's see, Pinterest. So all kinds of different sizes already in here for you. The other thing that's great here at the top, it says use custom dimensions. If one of these doesn't suit, you can use a custom dimension. So let's go ahead and I'm gonna do an Instagram post. So I just downloaded that image. So I'm gonna use that. And so what I did was I just, I uploaded the image here and I selected the image that I have. Then uploaded it, and then what I just did was clicked on it and dragged it over to where we're going to create our image. And then I'm just using the mouse to resize it, and then I can just drag it over as well to center it. And then you're going to add some text to it. That is over here on the far left. And I'm just going to add something. I clicked on that and it popped up over here on my picture, and you can just start typing. And you can put any number of things. Sometimes I use quotes. Sometimes I just type something cute that I want to put on there. So what I'm doing is just resizing it, but you can highlight this and then go up here. Change the font size. You can also change the font. Let's see, I'm going to, okay, and then maybe do a little bit larger font. You can also change the color. See if another color looks better. You can pick one of the colors that are here, or you can click here and select off of the color wheel, or if you know the code, you can put that as well. If you have different color schemes for your business, you can use that as well. You can also see how it has a rather large spacing. You can also go up here and change the spacing and just make that a little bit smaller. Okay. Then one thing you can do, you notice how you can center it. There it is centered. The other thing is, if you want to add elements to it, over here on the far left, if you want to add a shape, let's say I want to use this shape here. I'm just going to click on it. It will put it here. Then I'm going to the far right where it says arrange, and I'm going to put it back one, and then the color of my text was white, so I'm going to change that and maybe do a different color, green. But then I can take that So I'm clicking back and forth between the shape and the text. So what I can do is if I click on the shape there and I go up here to the far right, transparency, it's at 100. I can change the transparency so that you can read the text but you can see the image behind it. One thing that you may want to do, and then this can be made larger and moved. And there you see where it's centered a little bit. And then because of that, the spacing might want to be a little bit. Okay. And then the next thing I like to do is add my logo. And then you just make it smaller, put it wherever you want to place it. And let's see, let me make this a little bit more transparent. Oops. Oh, it's a little bit more transparent. Okay. And so then you can just up here, you can download it, or you can, where it says, it typically will put in the title of it, and that will be what the first text usually is. You can change that here if you like. I'm just gonna leave that for now. Then you can click on download and download your image. You can type in what type of image you want it to be and then download that. And then once it's downloaded, you can save that. And then you can find that and post that on your social media. The great thing that I do like about Canva is the fact that, so I'm going to go back to the front here. You can make all kinds of different sizes. If you're using doing a Facebook post, a Twitter post, if you're doing a blog and you want a blog title a different size, all kinds of different sizes that you can use with Canva, which I love. The other thing that's really great, so let's say I'm going to do a Facebook post. I have all of these free things over here on the left. You can really just pick something from here and change that and then put your logo on it. And there you go. That didn't take very long at all. So there's an image you can do in just a couple of seconds. It already had all of the information here for you. And you can just pick from one of these. You just click on it. They already had the text in there. Just change it to what you want to say. Add your logo. Delete anything you don't want on there. And simply download it. And that's a really fast way to do if you want to do a social media post really quick and don't have a lot of time. There are some quick and easy things you can do right there. And now for my bonus tip. Sometimes you go to places that have the free images and you can't exactly find really what you're looking for. So you're looking for some images that maybe aren't as expensive as some of the other places that cost a lot of money. So one of the places I like to go is Deposit Photos. And you can, a lot of times they'll have special deals. So it's a great thing to do to sign up for them. Sometimes they'll have special deals where you can get pictures for as low as a dollar. They have some great images in there. And so that is one of the places that I like to go to use that as an alternative if I want an image and I can't find anything in the different free CC0 image locations that I like to check. I have a free download for you. You can click it in the description below. It is the top 7 places I like to go to get my free CC0, that's Creative Commons 0, photos. They're free to use and make modifications too. I hope you enjoyed this video. Please click the like button, share it with your friends, and subscribe. I'm Tricia Clements, Chief Fur Wrangler with MuttButs.com. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.